almost looks like there's no way that this toothpick should bounce right on the end.
See how the water bends around the balloon?
Swain, in this one we're going to be making a lava lamp with no heat required.
Okay, for this science experiment we're going to be looking at a vacuum. There's one way you... Okay, for this experiment you're only going to need a couple things. Something tall, we're going to balance something on top of this. Two forks, two toothpicks, and I'm using a T-light as an anchor. You can use anything. You just need to be able to stick this toothpick into something so that it's sturdy and balances, okay? That's step one. Step two. Take the two forks, interlace them as tight as possible. The part's really important. These have got to be rock solid, okay? You don't want them moving at all. You're gonna take the other toothpick, and this part's really important, and weave it under the first tong and the first tong of the other one, right? So you get them balanced like that. This is where this part comes in. And this part takes a little patience, so bear with it if you don't get it the first try, okay? You can actually use center of gravity balance these two forks at the perfect center of gravity, and if you get it just right, the crazy thing about this is it uses center of gravity and it almost looks like there's no way that this toothpick should balance right on the end. Pretty cool, right? Okay, for this next experiment, we're going to be looking at the relationship between static electricity and water. This one's pretty cool and simple to do. We just need a balloon, some hair, and a water stream. I'll explain in just a second. The first thing we got to do is blow up this balloon. Okay, now that we've done that, we're going to tie this off. Blow the hair inside. And we're going to statically electrocharge this balloon, but first I'm going to need some help from my assistant. Well, aren't you looking dapper? You mind helping me out? So what you're gonna do with this part is you have to statically electrocharge this balloon. So we're gonna rub this on Kylo because he's got a lot of hair. Now you can use your own head, I just prefer to use my assistant, especially since he got all dressed up this morning. So now we're gonna head back over to the sink. We got the balloon statically electrocharged. It's gonna be able to bend the water if you get a really, really light stream of water. So this part's important. It's gotta be really small, something like that. And then check this out. See how the water bends around the balloon? Pretty cool and easy one to do. You can try this at home.
Swain, in this one we're gonna be making a lava lamp with no heat required. The things you need are some vegetable oil, a glass with some water in it, and then an Alka-Seltzer tablet. You need that. What's optional are food coloring and then a flashlight that just makes it look a little bit better. Okay, so the first thing we have to do is turn this water green. It'll just help visually. That's not right. One second. Okay, there we go, that's a little bit better. Now we're gonna mix in some vegetable oil, and here's where the science part comes in. Because water molecules are so tightly packed, they'll sink to the bottom where the vegetable oil rises to the top, so they separate. You can see that pretty clearly here. There's still some molecules suspended in there, but they'll mix out. Next, the last step is to just break up this Alka-Seltzer tablet and drop it in. So here's what's happening. As that bubbles the water to the top, it still stays separate in the oil, so it'll start to create this lava lamp-like effect. Without any heat, you see those bubbles start to rise. It's pulling the water molecules through the oil, and then when you hit it with the flashlight, it kind of just gives it this little extra added effect.
Okay, for this experiment, we're gonna look at carbon dioxide. This one's pretty cool. We're gonna use a couple things. Baking soda, you leave a glass, some vinegar, a candle, and a lighter. So this one involves fire. So kids, if you're doing this one, make sure a parent's with you to help you with this part. So let's get into it. Here's what we're gonna do first. We're going to light the candle so that it gets burning. Just like that. Then we are going to add in some baking soda to our glass. Gotta use a good amount here. Okay, and once that's in, we're gonna add a little bit of vinegar. So this actually creates a reaction in which the byproduct is carbon dioxide. Now, this is in the air that we breathe every day, but it's a little bit heavier. So as soon as that carbon dioxide forms, it stays inside the glass. Now, because it's heavier, it'll crash, it has weight. So what we can do is actually pour out this candle without ever getting it wet. Pretty cool, right? Something easy you can do at home, and pretty fun to do. Okay, for this science experiment, we're gonna be looking at a vacuum. There's one way you can create it, and not one to clean your floors. This is like a void of air. You need a glass, some water in it, a plate, a candle, and a lighter. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take this glass of water, pour it onto the plate, so you get a nice, good layer of water. Okay? And take the candle, usually light it first. And if you're doing this as a kid, make sure your parent does this part, okay? Don't do this without a parent, but you want that to be lit, like that. And then the best part about doing this with a tea light is that they'll float, okay? So I'm gonna let that burn for just a bit. And what it's doing right now is consuming oxygen around it. That's the only way fire can survive. So if it has a ton of oxygen around it, it'll continue to burn. But something happens when you get rid of its oxygen. So that's what we're doing there. We've completely sealed it off from the water, right? That candle will continue to burn the oxygen that's left inside that glass. And this works better the bigger the glass you have. There's more space inside it, right? So the candle's just about to burn out. And as it does, there's no more oxygen left inside this glass. That's a different air mass now than what's outside. So it starts to vacuum up the water, and it'll actually pull it through underneath the glass despite it being sealed. Pretty cool, right?